So let's try this, let's try answering this sample problem. Determine the allowable design axial load on a 300 mm square short type column reinforced with 4 diameter 28 mm bars, ties are diameter 10 mm, space at 300 mm. Use Fc prime is equal to 27.6 megapascal and Fy equal to 414 megapascal. Okay, so let's try to visualize the column section that is being described by the question. So we have a square column. Let's say, for example, this is the square column. So it is a square. So ang dimension daw ng isang side ay 300 mm. So this is 300 mm. And of course, this is also 300 mm since it is square. Okay. And then it has 4 diameter 28 mm bars. Say for example, ito yung reinforcement niya. 1, 2, 3, 4. So ang yan ay 4 diameter 28 mm. Okay, and then it has ties with diameter 10 mm. Say for example, these are the ties. Yan. And it is a diameter 10 mm at 300 mm on center. Okay, so we are being tasked to design the allowable design axial load. Okay, kumbaga hinahanap natin dito is yung ano ba yung pinakamalaking load that this section can withstand. Okay, so if you will try to refer sa code, ito nga yung sa section 22.4.42, as I mentioned before, naka-specify na dito yung maximum lang na axial load na pwedeng i-resist ng isang column, especially yung mga short column nga. Okay? So yung tinatawag natin na PN max. Okay? So since we are dealing with a column with ties and it is non-pre-stress obviously. Non-pre-stress siya and may tie siya. So ang magiging formula natin will be this 0.8 ng PO, wherein yung PO natin ay eto. Okay, that is what we want to find out, yung PN max na yan. Although ang hinahanap dito design axial load. So when we have we see na may word na design sa question, it's a clue na ang kailangan natin ay yung naka-reduce na. Okay. For the case of columns, since ang main na purpose ng column ay to resist compression, if we will try to refer sa table 421.2.2, and we know for that na since ang column may main purpose is to resist compression, therefore we can classify it as compression control. Kung ang reinforcement niya ay spiral, ang phi dyan will be 0.75. Otherwise, kung ties yan, it will just be 0.65. And since we are dealing with ties, so obviously ang phi natin will be 0.65. Okay? So ang hinahanap natin PU, and we know that PU is just equal to phi times PN, but since ang maximum yung hinahanap natin, yung allowable, this will be phi PN max. Okay? That will be phi PN max. Yun yung magiging PU natin. Okay? Where yung phi natin will be 0.65. Okay? So the first thing that we have to compute there is yung PO. Okay? So ang PO natin will be 0.85 Fc prime. So, idediretso ko na lang dito since dito na rin naman yung formula. Fc prime natin ay 27.6 and then times Ag, which is the gross cross-sectional area, gross concrete area, yung Ag, which is just 300 square. 300 times 300 or 300 square. Minus Ast, yung area ng reinforcement. So, it is 4 times pi over 4 times 28 squared. $25K. And then plus FY, which is 414. Ito ko na lang lagay sa 414 times AST ulit, which is 4 times pi over 4 times 28 squared. Okay. So if we will try to compute that, our PO will be 0.85 ng 27.6 times 300 squared minus 4 times pi over 4 times 28 squared plus 414 times 4 times pi over 4 times 28 squared. So, ang lalabas dyan ay naka-Newton. So, kung idediretso ko na siyang kilo-Newton, it will be 3,073.31 or 30 lang. 30 kilo-Newton. 3,073.30 kilo-Newton. Okay. And since ang PN max natin is 0.8 ng PO, therefore, our PN max will be equal to 0.8 ng PO, which is 3,073.30. So this will be 0.8 times 3,073.3. This will be 2,458.64 kilonewton. So yan lang yung maximum nominal axial strength ng column natin allowed by the code. Okay, kahit ang maximum niya talaga na kayang i-resist supposedly ay 3,073.30. The code doesn't want us to use that maximum. Ang gusto ng code gamitin lang natin is yung 80% lang yan or yung 2,458.64 kilonewton yan. Okay, but that is not the answer that we are searching for because ang kailangan natin ay yung allowable design axial load. So we just have to multiply that this PN max by phi for us to be able to get PU. So our PU will now be equal to phi, which is 0.65 times PN max 2,458.64. So this will be, so times 0.65 ko na lang yung kanina. So it will be 1,598.12 kilonewton. Okay. Times 0.65, yeah, 1,598.12 kilonewton. Okay, so basically yan yung maximum or yung allowable design axial load that our given column can withstand. And that is already the answer for this particular problem. So i-box na lang natin for it to be final. Okay, so if we want to check other parameters for this column, for example, yung amount ng reinforcement niya, which is yung rho, we can also do so. Okay, because we know that according to the code, there are minimum and maximum longitudinal reinforcement. Okay, so if we will try to check yung rho, or sometimes ang tawag na rin natin dito ay rho g, kasi it's the rho of the steel ratio of the whole section eh. If we will try to check yung rho g, rho g is just equal to AST divided by AG. Okay. So yung AST natin ay 4 pa times pi over 4 times 28 squared divided by AG na 300 squared. So that will be equal to 4 times pi over 4 times 28 squared divided by 300 squared. So that will be equal to 0.02737 5 decimal lang. Okay, 0.02 73 Yeah, 7. Okay, or approximately ilang percent yan? That is 2 decimal places to the right. That is 2.7%. Okay, that is 2.7% ng AG. Okay, kasi pag tinignan mo itong formula na to, pag multiply natin yung AG sa right side, magiging AST is equal to 2.7% ng AG. And according sa code, ang AST natin, yung longitudinal reinforcement natin, must be within 1% ng AG hanggang 8%. Okay? And since 1% is less than rho G na 2.7%, which is also less than sa 8%, therefore, okay tayo. Okay tayo pagdating sa reinforcement. Wala tayong magiging problems. Okay? If we also want to check yung spacing ng ties, we can refer dito sa section 2572. So according naman doon, ang spacing ng ties will be depending on here sa tatlong to or sa dalawang to. Okay, yung clear spacing of at least 4/3 ng diameter ng aggregates, which is hindi naman natin makakompute kasi hindi naman given yung diameter ng aggregates, but we can just compute yung center to center spacing, which are 16 times the longitudinal bar diameter. So if you will try to check that, so for the spacing, let's check the spacing. Check spacing of ties. So magiging spacing natin or yung S will be the least of 16 times the longitudinal bar diameter, which is 28. So that will be equal to 16 times 28. That will be 448 mm. And then 48 times the diameter naman ng tie bar natin. Ang tie bar natin ay 10 lang. So this will be 480 mm. And then lastly, yung smallest dimension of the member. And since square lang naman to, ang smallest dimension niya ay 300 mm. So basically, ang mag-govern na spacing ng ties dyan will be this. Okay? Kasi siya yung pinakamaliit. So this will be the spacing that will govern. Okay? And since yung given naman na spacing ng ties natin ay 300 mm, so therefore okay din yung spacing ng ties natin with a given problem. Okay? So yan lang naman ay kung gusto nyo lang i-check yung steel ratio tsaka yung spacing ng ties. Pero basically, yung inahanap lang naman sa tanong ay yung PU, yung ultimate, yung maximum or yung allowable design axial load. Okay? Or yung simply VPN max. So maybe we can na it is more appropriate to call that as a VPN max na lang. Kasi pag ginamit natin yung PU, it's more of the demand. It's more of the demand. So instead of calling this as simply PU, let us just call that as VPN max, so that it will be more look like the capacity of the section rather than PU. Kasi pag sinabi PU, parang load kasi or demand. Okay, so basically ang answer lang dito will be 1598.12 kilonewton. So yan yung maximum na kayang resist na tong given natin na section.